Welcome to my class. In this class, we are going to talk about real-time and uniprogramming operating system. There are different types of operating systems. The complexity level of operating system may vary according to, first, the number of users supported, second, the processing time required, and the third one is availability of technology. On the basis of these three factors, we can determine the complexity level of operating system. All operating systems can be classified as depicted in the following diagram. On the basis of number of users supported and on the basis of CPU utilization. On the basis of number of users supported, we have two types of operating systems. The first one, single user operating system, and the second one, multi-user operating system. On the basis of CPU utilization, we have multitasking operating system, multi-programming operating system, multi-processing operating system, real-time operating system, and uniprogramming operating system. Now, on the basis of CPU utilization, we have real-time operating system. Those operating systems which are bound to respond within a predefined time period, these are termed as real-time operating system. This type of operating system is desirable in controlling different processes in an industry. The operating system monitors the inputs into a system which affects the execution of processes, then seeing that desired output is made available within the prescribed time period. They are used for such tasks as navigation, in which the computer must react to a steady flow of information without interruption. Most general purpose operating systems like DOS and Unix, these are not real time because they take a few seconds or even few minutes to react. Since real time operating system has to respond quickly, they are used in vital applications such as landing of aircraft being monitored by air traffic controller at the airport. This is a photograph of air traffic controller office, where people are monitoring physically the landing and takeoff of aeroplanes. In this case, the information has to be given as and when it is required by the pilots. There cannot be any delay in the transmission of information. We cannot afford to have delay in these cases. The next one on the basis of CPU utilization is uniprogramming operating system. The uniprogramming operating system allows one task to be processed at a time. The execution of the next pending task shall take place only when the first task is completely processed. For example, if a user gives print command and the print command is under execution, in that case, the user cannot give another command to do the other task. In this type of operating system, CPU remains idle when input-output bound jobs are being performed. And at the same time, input and output resources remain idle when CPU bound jobs are being performed. Thank you very much.